Hello, this is Noah again, and now I'll tell you about MUF, a framework for modular static analysis of higher order languages. So what is MUF exactly? MUF stands for Modular Analysis Framework. It's a Scala framework that facilitates the development of static analysis. Recall that a static analysis allows you to reason about the behavior of a given program without actually running that program. Specifically, MUF helps you develop modular analyses. As you probably know by now, a modular analysis analyzes a program by splitting it up into different components, then analyzing these in isolation of one another. Components can be function calls, threads, compilation units, and so on. In summary, we can say that a modular analysis consists of both an intracomponent and an intercomponent analysis. The intracomponent analysis analyzes a single component. Therefore, it depends on the choice of components used in the modular analysis. For instance, if components are functions, the intracomponent analysis corresponds to an intra-procedural analysis. The intercomponent analysis is basically the algorithm that coordinates the modular analysis. It repeatedly analyzes components using this intracomponent analysis. That is, whenever one intracomponent analysis updates the analysis state, it schedules intracomponent analysis for all components that may have been affected by that change. This algorithm is completely independent of the choice of components and therefore the same for every modular analysis. Our framework basically takes away much of the complexity of correctly coordinating modular analyses. It only expects the analysis developer to provide a definition of components and the corresponding definition of an intracomponent analysis to analyze such components. From these definitions, it then generates automatically the entire modular analysis for free. So the good news is that an intracomponent analysis is usually relatively easy to implement. For instance, if components are functions, writing an intraprocedural analysis is quite easy, or at least much easier than writing an interprocedural analysis. In addition, MUF provides several Scala traits that make it even easier to develop the intracomponent analysis. As an example, let's see how we can build a function modular analysis for Scheme. That is a modular analysis where components correspond to function calls. For this purpose, we'll define a class scheme mod analysis here. Every modular analysis in MUF extends mod analysis, either directly or indirectly. And mod analysis is basically the root class of the framework. It provides the main infrastructure of the modular analysis. It drives the intercomponent analysis given a definition of the intracomponent analysis. First, mod analysis expects us to provide a definition of components. In a function modular analysis, components correspond to function calls. Therefore, a component is either the main component representing all top-level code or a call component representing a call to a specific closure. Next, we need to define an intra-component analysis for our components. We do this by defining an inner class scheme intra-analysis, which should provide a single method analyze to analyze a given component. The nice thing about implementing this method is that it's relatively easy. Since components are functions, we can just analyze them using a very simple intraprocedural analysis. In this case, that boils down to doing a big step recursive eval over the function's body. For instance, to evaluate a variable, what we do is we look up its address in the environment, then read that the value at that address in the store using this read other method. Read other is provided by the global store thread, which, as the name implies, can be used for analyses that require a global store. And behind the scenes, read other ensures that the modular analysis will reanalyze the current component whenever the value at that address that is read is going to be updated. Now, global store is just one of the many Scala traits in MUF that make up its extensible and reusable design. Another example of this are the traits that MUF provides to customize the worklist algorithm of the modular analysis. The worklist algorithm determines how and in what order components are analyzed. For instance, one of the options here is to analyze multiple components in parallel using a parallel worklist algorithm, which I already told you about earlier today. So as you can see, there are multiple traits to choose from here, and they are all directly compatible with any modular analysis. Other traits are specific to scheme analysis and used to easily configure the precision of the analysis. For instance, MUF provides several implementations for abstract domains for scheme, which can directly be plugged in into any scheme analysis. It also provides several traits to pick from to configure the context sensitivity of the analysis. In the end, this makes it very easy for the user to create different analyses with different configurations. For instance, this code here creates a function modular analysis for scheme that is context insensitive, uses a constant propagation domain, and a last in first out worklist algorithm. Alternatively, this code shows how one can create a one CFA context-sensitive analysis in Scheme, also using a different abstract domain and a different worklist algorithm. So as you can see, many combinations are possible. Next to function modeler analysis, MUF also provides process modeler analysis for Scheme, which can be used to analyze concurrent programs. However, we don't really have the time to get into that now. Now, during the development of MUF, we adopted several practices that we believe are relevant to any static analysis developer. For instance, MUF is bundled with several Scheme benchmarks collected from various sources that we can directly run our analyses on to test their correctness and efficiency. For this purpose, MUF also contains automated procedures to evaluate both the precision and the performance of our analyses on these benchmark programs. It also comes with soundness tests to automatically verify the correctness of our analyses. To guarantee the correctness and efficiency of our analysis throughout their development, we've also set up a continuous integration pipeline that periodically runs these procedures. And finally, MUF also includes a visual debugger, which can be used to step through a modeler analysis and inspect its results at any given point. So far, this has been useful to us in two ways. One, as an analysis developer, to debug unexpected analysis behavior. And second, as an analysis user, to provide a visual and interactive representation of the analysis results. So in summary, we've introduced MUF here, a framework to develop modeler analysis. The project is open source and can be found at the following link here in case you missed it previously. So to recap the main strengths of MUF, it allows you to automatically construct a modeler analysis given the definition of an intra-component analysis. It supports dynamic higher order languages such as Scheme or JavaScript. It allows you to easily configure the precision and performance of your analysis. It features a reusable and extensible design using Scala traits. And finally, it offers analysis developer integrated tools to verify, evaluate, and inspect analysis created in MUF. So that's all for my brief introduction to MUF. Let's conclude with two questions here. First, how do you think one should balance the engineering efforts that goes into the development of a framework like MUF with the effort that is actually spent on using this tool as a vehicle to conduct research? And second, do you think that all analysis prototypes should employ a suite of soundness, performance, and precision tests as we are doing here in MUF? Thank you for listening.